Clear the shop. I want some pop. Look at all the flavors. Pick what you want.
Orange. Grape. And soda.
Ginger ale.
And I'll have a plain soda water.
Maybe I didn't go far in school, but there's one thing I've learned from my mom and dad.
Look after the nickels and dimes, and the dollars will look after themselves.
Right?
Right on!
They've got big bottles, too.
And I've got a nose for value.
Now, as I told you earlier, we have some friends back with us, and sitting on my very far right is Eddie Shack, who is the Vice President of Public Relations for Pop Shoppe, which actually it's not an honorary, it's a real title, isn't it, Eddie? And that's, you were awarded that last time you were on our show, actually, as I recall.
But all my school teachers in Sudbury, and as far as I went was grade three, they'd be really proud of me now.
To think that you made vice president. Listen, we'll get you into the presidency today, okay? Sitting next to me is Bill May. And Bill, you're the general manager for Canada and also the vice president of marketing for the international?
Pop Shoppe International.
Pop Shoppe International.
Right.
It's terrific.
Well,
and it's really growing, too.
Yes, it is. Yeah, we're in a lot of different areas and major cities in the United States, but most of our efforts and activities are still in Canada.
Yeah.
We derive most of our successes, and we have a very good base of operation in Canada. We have to be very careful how quickly we move out into other areas and not get ourselves too extended.
That's a very good point. What I'd like to do, some people that are watching the show today probably didn't see the interview that we did last time. I shouldn't say probably didn't, if they're not first time.
That's right.
For everything.
Exactly.
Can we just sort of refresh very slightly on Pop Shoppe? Because one thing that I found out last time that I didn't realize was that Pop Shoppe is a Canadian operation, and the concept originated here.
Yes, it did. Well, really, it's we are now 11 years old. I think the last time we were here, we were celebrating our 10th our 10th year in business. We are definitely, and we like to underline that very much, an all-Canadian company. We have ventured into the United States. We've also ventured into Australia. Our situation is that we, in 10 years ago, the concept and idea was created in London, Ontario. And from there, it's really blossomed. We have got a healthy share of the Canadian market. We have pioneered the concept of cash and carry pop. We certainly are the undisputed leaders. If we could say we were number one in any category, it would be selling by the case. Certainly the majors, they sell everywhere, and they also spend very, very big dollars in marketing. That's probably one of the major differences between ourselves and the majors, is that our dollars are, pardon the pun, but very gorilla-like. And Eddie's not the gorilla.
He's
the keynote behind our whole
heavy
market. That's right, he is the heavy. But he's eating butter now.
God,
but
I
his
like
wife doesn't know it yet.
But the whole point from our business is that we try to give good pop for good prices. And our concept is built around using the same bottle for all our flavors, the only difference being the crown.
Crown, yeah.
Using the case, which you can, and mix and matching a lot of flavors, over 20 now with our new non-carbonated. So that's, thank
what
you.
What are you into, Eddie? Is that the grape or the passion?
The grape.
Oh, I thought you might have had passion on
is
my
that
show.
Grape with or without bubbles?
Without the bubbles.
Without the bubbles. I have to tell you one funny story. I know that maybe we're going to lead into our non-carbonated nectars, but Eddie was doing a commercial, radio commercials, with Henri Richard, and we had a little contest to see who could say non-carbonated. And I was there, and I can safely tell you, neither one.
Neither of them were successful.
But Eddie, being the creative guy he is, and he really writes a lot of our marketing, only because of the way he is and his enthusiasm, he turned around and said, well, then I'm just going to say that we have drinks with bubbles and drinks without bubbles. And that's what we incorporate into our advertising and marketing, is it's, Eddie says, our no-bubble drinks.
Well, this is, in fact, the new product that we were talking about earlier.
Yes, it is.
And I'm rather pleased, too, because I don't like bubbled. I was trying
uncarbonated.
To get the tense.
Uncarbonated. Oh, very good, Ed. Very good.
I was trying to get the tense right for bubble, you see. Now bubble's got to become a verb, right? But I don't like drinks that are carbonated. And so I'm particularly pleased that you've come up with this. Because it's very difficult to
and
go out
and
do
like?
Anything.
What kind of a drink do you like?
Well, I think I'd like to try a peach, please.
Right. Ooh, a little peach.
Peach. I think we got peach here.
I bet that's
you
not.
Check the crown. That's very good. You don't have to worry about now the fizzing up.
Yeah, that's right, too. Watch me spill it. Or choke.
Oh, your father's watching.
Well, here, I'm going to have, I'll have an apple. And then we can drink a chimo.
That's very tasty. That's not too, thick. It's not like it's
it's not the syrupy
it's not so,
anticipation
that's right.
Yes. Of
a
nectar. I agree.
Yeah. When you say nectar, okay. Let's come back to the whole product for a moment, and let's talk about your marketing concepts.
Sure.
First of all, how did you research it? What made you decide on the flavors that you have? Did you test market?
Well, we did. As a matter of fact, we did all of those things. What happened was a year ago, we had had a lot of pressures from our licensees who are very much more closely associated with their consuming public mm-hmm. in their marketplaces. And there had been, for I guess the last two or three years, a lot of requests from our bottlers across the country mm-hmm. that we would provide a non-carbonated line of drinks.
Mm-hmm.
So last year we created lemonade in our secret kitchens in Stratford, and with the success of the lemonade, we went out and went back to the kitchens and said, look, with the growth of this segment, and the largest, one of the fastest growing segments in the soft drink industry is the non-carbonated line.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people are like yourself, Ann, who just prefer at different times during the day to have a non-carbonated drink.
Absolutely.
Biggest selling flavors are things like lemonade, orange, grape, and apple. We have created
a trend, peach, folks.
Well,
peach
and
is great.
Peach. Ed is very big on the passion punch, and I think that's self-explanatory. My favorite is apple, but we also have cranberry
uh-huh.
and iced tea, which is also another very popular drink for the summertime. So between the, from the test market successes, and we knew that our that we did those in London and Kingston, we found that the consumer definitely made a move to the non-carbonated line.
Mm-hmm.
So we planned an entire rollout and brought the products to the consumer right across Canada on May 1st. And we are very, very pleased with
yeah.
the success.
Very and it's
pleased.
Coming on well. Are you, now, this is originated in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Will you spin this out to on an international basis, or?
Well, let's put it this way: we are definitely looking at it. Again, we're running into requests from bottlers in mm-hmm. Los Angeles, San Francisco, Denver, Portland, saying that they would like definitely lemonade and apple, and we're in the process of.
You get different taste buds in different parts
well,
of
sure
the country
do.
And
exactly,
the world.
Because. Apple is very, very popular in the western uh-huh. part of the United States.
What are the kids like, Eddie? Have you done any research there and figured out what they're interested in?
Basically the grape.
And, yeah.
And orange, a lot of the Indian kids like the orange drink.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and there's the Italian people, you know, they like the ginger
yes.
ale. You know, they have a thing that... right across Canada, that they're just different
yeah.
taste buds. The Maritimes, they have a different. They have the
well, they like cranberry. Very interesting. Cranberry yeah. and apple are being tested most often.
Mm-hmm.
And the other thing that we're finding, and it's very pleasing to our business, is that with the cranberry and the peach. We and apple, we have found that that's bringing in a whole different group to our outlets. We're seeing older people who just were not as interested in the Pop Shoppe concept because we strictly had had carbonated drinks. Now with the non-carbonated selection, we are seeing a different age group coming in.
Well, also you're getting the non-party situation too, because
that's right.
I can see me going in and buying a case of peach.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's what I like. But I wouldn't go in and buy a case of ginger ale or something like that, unless I was giving a party, and right. then it makes sense to go and buy everything.
With the tonic,
shops.
With the soda.
Yeah.
Well, the other thing, too, that we have found is that everything is mix and match. Mm-hmm. We have priced, and been fortunate enough because of our production inefficiencies, we have been able to price our non-carbonated as well as our carbonated. So someone can come in, buy his cola, his tonic, and his soda, and also throw in lemonade and apple.
Mm-hmm.
And mothers are looking forward to what we're finding, too, in our telephone interviews with mothers is that they like to see their kids drinking apple and lemonade through the week. Sometimes in my home, specifically, my kids don't get a shot at carbonated drinks
mm-hmm.
until the weekend. And
what's in here?
Well, interestingly enough, our
just talking about mothers, I'm thinking, okay, what's the question right. mothers are going to have? Nutrition, right?
I know they are, and
yeah.
We have put a hint of honey, but everything in, unfortunately or fortunately, the soft drink is not what I would call a fully nutritional situation. What it is a combination of flavoring and flavor additives that have been put together in an appetizing blend.
Mm-hmm.
I cannot go out and will not go out and say that, hey, this is the most nutritional drink. It's very refreshing and will provide you with a great deal of pleasure, but not a great deal of nutritional value.
Mm-hmm. I want to come back to Hint of Honey for a moment because
okay.
I was just thinking about the picture that we saw
right.
of the one of your promotional pieces, which is the one advertising nectar.
The little bee.
The little bee.
Right.
And you were telling me earlier that you're going to ask people to give you a name for the bee.
Well, one of the things that we have a Mr. Pop Shoppe and we have a Mr. Pop Shoppe, so we have created this little bee to sort of dramatize the honey flavoring.
There he is.
And
yeah.
so in discussion with a lot of the people in our company, we have said, look, to draw attention to the little bee and to make him sort of part of Eddie's team,
uh-huh.
we need a name for him. So we're looking forward to putting together a program
uh-huh.
of Name the Pop Shoppe Bee. And
Bo Peep? Can I start?
Bo Peep is one. My yeah. son, he wanted to call him Bilingual Bee.
Yes.
So.
Yes,
at
Eddie.
The sick kids hospital that I was given the little girl that won the name of the helicopter, and it was called Bandage Number One, and then they're going to go on like that. So the girl got a nice little prize, and it was really something to see it.
But it's nice to see that. It's yeah. right when you. I love to get the kids involved in things like that.
And she just wrote up just a beautiful article, and
yeah.
you know, and then the kids. Some of the kids have been flown on top of the hospital of the sick kids, and
mm-hmm.
And saved a lot of lives too.
It is amazing. It's funny because when I used to hear that thing go over, I thought it was coming from one of the military installations because it makes a heck of a noise.
Yeah.
And but it's really done some wonderful things. And it's not just for the children either. That helicopter's being used for other people as well to
mm-hmm.
come in.
From Sudbury and
yeah.
Kingston and
That's
London
right.
and all over.
Yeah.
So I think there's three of them now.
It's an excellent service.
It is, isn't it?
It really is.
You're talking about bilingual. You brought up the bilingual point there a moment ago, and I just want to come back on for a moment for the marketing techniques.
Right.
Because you were telling me that you're actually trying to assist people, really, also in other areas. And you've got here, I think I'll hold it up if I may, but you've got these in all different languages, haven't
yes,
you?
Yes, we have. It's the first time we've ever done this from a marketing standpoint, but we have recognized in Toronto the
mm-hmm.
very, very large Italian community. And we feel that it's important to communicate as best we can in the language that they understand
mm-hmm.
the most. So we are communicating now in Italian, French, and English. And
mm-hmm.
This was our key marketing vehicle, was that we send out through direct mail to every home, or hoped every home, and through across country, across Canada, 6 free bottles. And it was just to sort of have
You're going to have a multilingual name for the bee? Can you imagine all sorts of things?
Well,
you're
really
going to have a translator to make sure that they're sending in absolutely clean suggestions.
That's
you
right.
Know,
I never thought
problems.
Of that, but that's true.
Yes.
We're going to get language suggestions
uh-huh.
from all across the country. So we'll have
if
to.
If people are
name.
Sending in suggestions, where should they send them to?
Well, as a matter of fact, I would send them to the attention of Mr. Pop Shoppe,
mm-hmm.
which is Pop Shoppe International, and that's 1 Eva Road right here in Toronto.
In Toronto. Terrific.
And don't ask me the postal code.
You can't give it. Okay. And then, Eddie, we're going to have the pleasure of having you back on the program in, quite a few weeks now, I guess, in September, when we take a look at the hockey school. Thanks, both of you, very much for joining us today.